adopted as a baby. And my mom had already adopted one child. That was my brother. I was adopted 4 years later. And I think there's something that makes adopted children special. Because I think sometimes parents who have children naturally, they can look at that child. And there's certain things they do when they're small, and you're like, oh my God, that's just like me. But sometimes with adopted children, they do these things when they're really small children, and all you're thinking is, what the fuck? I don't see myself in that at all. And I think it might be easier to separate yourself from it. So I had this habit of doing weird things at Christmas. When I was young, between 0 and 3, I lived in the Upper West Side of Manhattan. So every year, we would go down to go get the picture taken with Santa Claus at Macy's, like the famous, you know, David Sedaris made famous or whatever, but it was a thing that you did every year. And when I went, you got all dressed up. You did it like a month before Christmas, like right after Thanksgiving. And that day I was probably about a year and a half, about 18 months. So I was wandering around, and I had taken a bath and gotten dressed in this beautiful Christmas outfit my mother was very proud to have found. And I was shorted on my bath. This was a problem, because I loved baths so much so that I got really upset about this. But my parents moved on to getting my brother ready and ignoring the fact that I was upset that I had not had a full bath. So dressed in my Christmas best with hose or, you know, tights and like these beautiful new shoes, my parents couldn't find me when they go to leave to take the picture of Santa. They have no idea where I am. Now, it is New York, so it's like a two-bedroom apartment. It shouldn't be too hard to find me. And they look and they look. Finally, they hear this cooing and somebody splashing. They had neglected to drain the bathtub. So I went in with all my clothes and played and played and played and played and ruined all my clothes. Now, they had had an appointment with this Santa Claus to get this picture. So my mom was forced to put me into some other red thing and take me down there. Now, I think my mother, who's very big about proper things and proper photos and proper behavior, was like, what the fuck? Like why would she do that? She was fully dressed. I was fully dressed. So that's number one. Number two, I just moved to Texas. And when I was about 3 and a half, we moved to Austin. So this was the first Christmas there. So I was probably like 3 and a half. It might have been the second Christmas, 4. We'd gone to this large mall. We were shopping, we were all hanging out together. I was holding onto my mom's hand. My brother was wandering around with my parents. At some point, my parents lost me. Now they claim that I got lost myself. I do not agree with that assessment at all, because I was not lost. I was just fine. I must have followed somebody else's skirt out of the store, because I don't know where they went, but I felt fairly confident I knew where I was. So while my parents were frantic, thinking I had been abducted, I went over and I waited in line and I got my picture with Santa, because apparently I love that from a small age. And this time I was not wet when I went to go see him. And you had to get a ticket, you had to pay something. I did neither. But somehow I got a ticket, and I got in line, and I waited by myself and got my picture taken of Santa. And then I got on the little train. Now, the train costs money, and you had to get a ticket. I don't know how I got on the train, but I got on the train. And I rode it several times. And my parents finally saw me. My parents are like, what the fuck? You're on the train? We thought you'd been kidnapped. We thought you were dead. And I'm just sitting there like with this ticket that I got my picture taken with Santa. was, like, being all happy. And I was not lost, but my parents were, and I'm glad they found themselves. And those are my two what the fuck stories.